Prime Minister Narendra Modi will visit Sri Lanka on Sunday, during which he will hold discussions with President Maithripala Sirisena. This will be Prime Minister Narendra Modi's third visit to Sri Lanka. Earlier, he visited the country in 2015 and 2017. Additional Secretary, Union Home Minister Gyanesh Kumar called on Jammu Kashmir's Governor Satyapal Malik and discussed about the arrangements for the smooth conduct of Amarnath Yatra, scheduled to begin next month. Kumar, who was accompanied by senior intelligence officers, briefed the governor regarding the foolproof arrangements being made for the pilgrimage, including en route facilities for the devotees and security issues. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee today wrote a letter to Prime Minister Narendra Modi expressing her inability to attend the Niti Aayog meeting on June 15, saying it is fruitless as the body has no financial powers to support state plans. Prime Minister Modi is set to chair the fifth meeting of the Niti Aayog's Governing Council on June 15 to discuss various issues regarding the country's development. In what could be an unprecedented move, Andhra Pradesh Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan Mohan Reddy today decided to have five deputy chief ministers under him in a full 25-member cabinet. The chief minister held a meeting of the YSR Congress Legislature Party at his residence, where he announced the decisions to appoint five deputy chief ministers. Accordingly, one each from scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, backward, minority and Kapu communities would be made a deputy chief minister. He said the cabinet would be reconstituted 2.5 years later after a midterm review of the government's performance. Security forces today recovered a cache of arms and ammunition from a terrorist hideout in Jammu and Kashmir's Doda district. Based on a specific information about terrorist hideouts and movement of suspected militants, troops of Rashtra Rifles along with sleuths of police launched a joint operation in Chili Bhala area of Tartri of district Doda. Weather turned pleasant in Kashmir Valley after recording below normal temperature due to intermittent rain for the past couple of days, where upper heights of the world-famous ski resort of Gulmarg received fresh snowfall. However, a fresh spell of snowfall was predicted in the valley under the influence of a western disturbance which will hit the region on June 10. According to the Met Department, isolated light rain and thunder showers would occur during the next 48 hours in the valley. Terrorists gunned down a territorial army jawan who was home for Eid in Anantnag. Manzoor Beg from Sadora was home on Eid. He was declared brought dead to the hospital. Manzoor was spotted at Shopian district and was attacked with 34 battalion of the Rashtra Rifle. At least 17 people died and several others were injured when a tourist bus travelling from Oman met with an accident in Dubai on Thursday evening. Indian Consulate has confirmed that 8 out of the 17 who died in the accident were Indian. The bus was returning after Eid celebrations in Oman when it crashed into the signboard. Delhi court grants bail to Congress leader Shashi Tharoor on complaint for his alleged scorpion remark.